Gokukoku no Brynhildr episode 6 came out today. This was a cool episode. I liked it a lot. I like the fact that all this serious type of stuff can happen, and then in like a split second, it'll be on some, you know, comedy type of just kicking back type of shit. That's cool to me that they can have those types of twists and turns and all that type of stuff, man. But let's go ahead and get into the episode. So just like what happened with last episode, that girl got blasted and she died. But Kikuko goes up to her body and removes the harness from the back of her neck. I also have a question though, because this is episode 6. I was waiting to see if I was going to see one, but I haven't seen one as of yet, and I don't think I will. But is there a reason why all of the magic users in this world are female? Is there any particular reason for that? Was it said and I just didn't notice it? Because it seems like they're all female. So I was just wondering, is there a reason why all of the witches in this are female? That's I was just wondering that. But yeah, she removes the harness from the girl's neck, and Kuroha was trying to go to... you know what's funny? I don't know exactly what the hell she thought she was going to be able to do, because yeah, it's sad this girl just died. But like Ryota was saying, he was like, there's nothing that we can do about it. You know what I'm saying? Your magic would be like ineffective against her own, so there would be nothing that you could do. And as she's trying to run away, he pushes the button on the back of her neck to make her hang up. I thought that was kind of cool too, though. You know, I wasn't expecting him to do that shit, so it seems like he has a full grasp of like how all this stuff works, and his mind is just playing out this type of stuff like right away. So I'm rocking with this dude's character. But after that though, he gets a call on the on his earpiece thing, and it is Kazumi saying that they need to hurry up and try to leave because of that blast. The police might be there, and if the police, you know, think to do a check, then they would be arrested and they'd be killed and that type of stuff. And as he was about to leave, she's like, wait, Katori is there. And Katori is literally screaming like an idiot, you know. She's like, hey, I'm here to save you, I'm here to save you. And I was just like, god damn. And so as she's doing that, Kuroha was like, I have a plan, I'm gonna distract Kikuko. So Ryota, you get Katori to go away. And then he was like, I have a plan. Like, he had a plan. And so he has Kuroha to go in front of Kikuko and you know, distract her enough to get Katori away. And then he notices that Kikuko's attack has a lag in it, so Kuroha is able to dodge it because of the lag that the attack has when she's powering up and when she's releasing it. And I thought that was cool. Man, again, this kid's mind just works in a very fast pace, in a very, very accessible way. Like, having him on their team is gonna actually do them wonders. You know what I'm saying? Like, they might live for a lot longer than what I previously thought. You know what I'm saying? The last review, because of his ability to adapt to his situations. I say he discovered the lag in Kikuko's ability, and afterwards he takes Katori away or whatever. He kind of lures her away, and he's trying to, you know, come up with a plan and all that type of stuff. And he notices that Katori has kind of ran away from where he's at, and she's tying her wrist to a pole. And that's when he puts together what exactly is going on with Kana's prediction, her forecast. Katori was going to switch places with Kuroha, I'm sorry, and she was going to die. You know, so that's what she was going to do. She was going to switch places. And with that that revelation, Ryota came with the conclusion, like, well, shit, we already won. He tied her wrist even tighter on the pole thing, and just as Kikuko had captured Kuroha and she was about to blast her at point blank range, he told her to switch places with Kikuko. So Kikuko ended up being tied to the pole, and Ryota pushed her button to hang her up, and then he put a bag over her head so that she couldn't see his face. smart move, right? You know, so that was smart. And like, he's thinking way ahead, though. Like, that was smart of him, you know what I'm saying, to do that. And then he tried to question her, and she just doesn't know the answers or whatever. And then they notice that Katori has ran away again. And she goes to this cabin or whatever. And her friend, Chie, who helped her escape and who kept her alive and all that type of stuff, she stopped taking the death suppressant pills and told Katori to live on, because Katori always wanted to go to high school and live a normal, regular life. And it just so happened that that day was Katori's birthday, and she turned 16. And that's, you know, considered to be a woman and all type of stuff, man. So she was able to kind of like reach somewhat adulthood and live a seemingly normal life. And she was ready to die. Like, she was going to stop taking death suppressant pills, and she was about to die. And she also explained that that's why she smiled all the time, was because Chie said that even in times of sadness, even in times of, you know, despair and all that, to smile. Just keep smiling. And I like Ryota's reaction to that. He was like, listen, I just got a freshman as a member of the club, so there's no way I can let you leave. It'll look bad on my part. And then he's like, take this pill. If not, I'll force it down your throat. So, you know what I'm saying? He's a good guy, man. He's trying to do this shit to make them live, man. Like, he's a good guy. He's thinking ahead, you know. And after all that, though, the police come, and it's all covered up and all that type of shit. And but after that, though, he sits them all down, because Katori starts to live in the observatory as well. And they all having like some little fun, you know, playing in the water and all that type of shit, because it's hot outside. But he sits them down, and he's like, listen, I want to tell someone about you guys. And they're like, can't he be trusted? And he was like, yeah, he can be trusted. He's just an asshole for the most part. And he goes to this guy. His name was Kogoro, I think. And something Ogoro. I know Ogoro is in it. I may have got that fucked up, because Kogoro is Richard's name. And case closed. Detective Conan, I'm sorry. But he goes to this guy, and he's talking to him. And this guy is a scientist at like a college and like a research facility or something like that. And he goes to him, and he's like, hey, you don't believe in the supernatural, you know what I'm saying? But what if I can prove it to you? Will you listen to what I say? And he even warns him beforehand, like, listen, you might be killed because of this information that I'm going to give you. I've already witnessed 2 people die so far. And he says that he wants to show this guy that the supernatural is real. And what he does is he has Kuraha come with him and blast an object in the room, and he blows up the computer. And the guy is like, nah, you could have easily planted some C4 in here. How about blowing up the floor right here? And it blew up. Just as he said it, it blew up. And then he's like, okay, this is my family heirloom pen. Blew up. You know, so he started smiling like, this is interesting. This is intriguing. Tell me everything. And that's how it ends. So he has a... I don't know how he knows this guy, you know, but apparently he knows this guy well enough to where he can, you know, trust him with shit like that. So this is interesting to see how this gonna develop, man. Like, he more than likely he might give that alien egg and PDA thing to that guy. That's what I'd do if I was in. Fuck, I mean, ain't nothing I can do with it. I would have gave it to that guy. So, you know, we're gonna see though, man. But like I said, man, this is shaping up to be a fucking interesting series, man. Again, I'm, you know, hype. I'm really hype. I can't wait. Every week I'm like, fuck, is it out? I'm just hype about this shit though, man, because it's a very, very interesting series. Let me know what you thought about the episode. Let me know what you think about that guy, something Ogoro. I want to say Kogoro, could be Sogoro, can't remember. Let me know what you think about his character. Let me know what you think about Ryota telling him about the situation. Can he be trusted, really? You know, let me know what you think is going to happen in the next episode. Bash Stampede, signing out.